Thank you. good evening. Welcome to our spring concert. One of the things that has perplexed me about being a band director is the absolute lack of really good new music. And the piece that you just heard was by a Swedish composer, Bertrand Göran. And I was very happy earlier this fall to discover a couple of publishing houses that have some wonderful young new composers on staff, and they're publishing this music. And actually, we've taken advantage of a number of these new young composers' works this year, and this was one of them. You actually heard a couple of the, or one of the pieces actually back in our December concert, Spirit of Independence. We're going to play another piece by British composer Philip Spark later on in the concert, and I'll tell you a little bit more about that when we get to it. The next piece that we have to perform is a piece that is not new, not by a young composer. It's actually one of the standards of the wind band repertoire, and one of my favorites. It's the English folk song suite by Ralph Vaughan Williams, who is another English composer. And we hope you enjoy it. We'll be performing the first and the third movements.
Thank you.
few short weeks ago, it seems like it was quite a while ago, but it really was just 2 weeks ago. And as you can see, we came back with some mementos, some souvenirs of our trip. We were very, very, very pleased with the results of our performances in Montreal, both the concert band and the jazz band. Both were rated excellent, as were all of the other three ensembles that were performing in the top ratings category, as we were. We all scored within points of each other, which I was very pleased. You know, we've never really done a competition per se, and I was a little bit nervous about doing something like that because I'm not really of the mind that you really need to be competing in music. But it was nice to go and see how we stood up against some of the other groups, and we fared very well against some schools that were considerably larger than our own and had some much larger music programs to draw their students from. So I'm very pleased with the work that the kids did up there. I'm also, I must say, extraordinarily, as I have been with the every single trip that we've taken, extraordinarily happy with their behavior and the way that they represented our town of Granby. And we're going to perform another selection that we played in Montreal. This is a piece by, as I mentioned before, a British composer, Philip Spark. Now, Philip Spark writes for the brass band, mostly. He's known in the British brass band circles as a new and exciting composer. And this piece that we're about to play is actually originally written for a brass band. Now, for those of you who have never heard of a British-style brass band, I actually happen to play in one. It's based in Willimantic, and we just came back last weekend from a brass band festival in New Jersey, and where we were actually treated to some of the finest brass bands throughout the Northeast, bands as far away from Ottawa, Canada, and even one band from England came over, an actual authentic British brass band. The thing that makes the British brass band distinct from what the ensemble that you see up here this evening is that it's made up of, well, obviously all brass instruments. Cornets, bugles, trumpets, French horns, upright bell French horns that are called peckhorns, which almost sound as nice as a French horn, but not as quite as nice. Euphoniums, baritones, trombones, tubas, and percussion. Now, the thing that makes the brass band really exciting is that they kind of pride themselves on playing music that goes as fast as they can possibly stand to play it. And that's one of the contest requirements for these bands, is that they really have to play something that's quite energetic, quite uplifting, and exciting to listen to. And I think that you're going to agree that the piece that we're about to embark on fits that requirement. This is transcribed from a British band, a British brass band composition called Navigation Inn. And again, the composer is Philip Spark. Hope you enjoy our performance. And again, I want to thank you for coming out this evening. After we perform this, we'll take a short intermission, and the jazz band will set up on stage here, and we'll play for you. So I hope that you will stay around and enjoy that performance. And one last thing before we play. I would be remiss not to mention my seniors this year, who we were just talking about this a few minutes ago. This is my fourth year here at Granby, and it's their fourth year here at Granby. And unfortunately for them, they're going to be moving, well, unfortunately for us, they're going to be moving on to bigger and better things. But I would like our seniors to stand up and just be recognized.